Hey, excuse me, however, I don't need a disclaimer. This is my channel. Argue with your pets. If you don't have one, maybe argue with your best friend. If you don't have that either, I can't help you. All opinions are mine, and that's that.
Hey guys, it's the Delphinator here, and this is Review Quickie. Let's talk about the Oscars, shall we? Jimmy Kimmel's performance. Can we just stop for a second to give Jimmy Kimmel a hand? You guys, come on, not that kind of hand. Gosh, no, this kind of hand. As I was saying, Mr. Kimmel delivered. His monologue was ace. His dings at Mel Gibson, his pseudo feud with Matt Damon, and his constant ironical quips at Meryl Streep were positively hilarious, and the show got off to a great start. Let's begin then. The fashion. The Hidden Figures ladies, who are not so hidden anymore, by the way, they didn't come to play, guys. They came to slay. Taraji P. Henson, Janelle Monáe, and Octavia Spencer all looked stunning. I also loved Hailee Steinfeld's look. Very ethereal. However, my absolute favorite look was Janelle's. Oh my goodness, that dress. The detailing, the bodice, the full skirts. Let me stop there. Then there was the mop of a thing that was Halle Berry's hair. What was that? Come on. Now, on to the floating candy. There was candy wafting down from the ceiling. It looked like something out of a Disney movie. Really cute stuff. It reminded me of Chris Rock's Girl Scout cookies from the previous year. And then there was Ellen DeGeneres' pizza bit, remember? Quick and easy snacks for the people. Now, on to Sunny Powers' all-round cuteness. Little Sonny stole our hearts in the movie Lion, and stole even more hearts when he appeared on the Oscars red carpet in that cute little tux. Aww. When Kimmel lifted him up for an impromptu reenactment of the iconic Simba scene from The Lion King, it was the most precious thing ever. Whatever that is. Now on to the tour bus bit. People say this bit didn't quite work, that the tour bus people should have at least had a say in whether or not they wanted to be a part of Kimmel's prank. Well, I quite disagree with that, because if they were told beforehand, then it would no longer be a prank. Guys, come on, lighten up. I thought it was funny and fresh. One of the tourists, Gary from Chicago, was so authentic. His expressions were gold. Also, he and his fiance had a quick wedding officiated by Denzel.
I now pronounce you husband and wife. Kiss the bride.
How cool is that? Now on to the speeches. What are the Oscars without heartfelt speeches? And as impassioned speeches go, Viola Davis's did not fall short.
I became an artist, and thank God I did, because we are the only profession that celebrates what it means to live a life.
Talent, sister. Other heart-tugging speeches were given by Emma Stone and Mahershala Ali. Now onto the awards. The reason why we all gathered in the first place. See the way I said all gathered, like I was there with them. Anyway, I was pretty stoked for first-time winners Mahershala Ali, Viola Davis, and Emma Stone. The last two being some of my favorite actors. So, La La Land did not clinch as many awards as expected. They even missed out on the Best Picture award, which was a shocker to say the least. I strongly believe that Steve Harvey may have had something to do with the La La Land Moonlight debacle that played out on
camera. I'm sorry, no. There's a mistake. Moonlight, you guys won Best Picture.
Moonlight won. Come on, this is not a joke.
This is not a joke. I'm afraid they read the wrong thing.
This is not a joke. Moonlight has won Best Picture. Moonlight, Best Picture.
Whatever the case, this is good for Moonlight because now the movie is being talked about and subsequently more people will go see it. And that's it, people. All in all, it was a well put together show. Jimmy Kimmel was a fantastic host, from teasing Oscar nominees to live tweeting at the Donald.
Here we go.
To floating candy, to the surprise visitors, to the mean tweets.
Now's probably a good time to remind everyone about this dog that looks like Tilda Swinton.
Now that was epic, very entertaining indeed. And so, ladies and gentlemen, I give the Oscars 2017 overall show a 4 jollof rating, complete with chicken. If you haven't seen it yet, go check it out. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section, okay? It's the Delphinator here. Always great hanging with you guys. Do not forget to subscribe, hit the thumbs up button, and share. Until the next one, toodles!